pleased to say we're going to take you all the way to the finish of the 2012 Daytona 200 here on Speed. And it's a fight between two 19-year-olds. Joey Pasquarella at the front on the Project One Atlanta Yamaha against the Works Yamaha of Cameron Beaubier. They've got enough margin over Martin Cardenas aboard his Geico Suzuki to just have their own private little battle to join us very special club.
Especially with the lap times they're cutting last time. They may have got notified that Martin was gaining on them. And now, the last time by, both of those guys went from 51s down into the 50s range lap time. So they know they've got to keep that pace up. They can't lay off at all, because this man right here will hunt them down.
4.2 seconds in arrears last time around. It's not inconceivable for him to slice that off. Dane Westby showed us earlier in the race, but it is a tough task. Let's run down the order for you. Behind him, we know DeSalvo's 4, Westby's 5, an agonizing 35 seconds back. He could have easily been the Daytona 200 winner today. Zemke is 6th, Corey West is 7th, Aquino is 8th, Tommy Hayden 9th, and Jake Gagner is 10th. Phenomenal battle up front, Greg.
It is, and this isn't the only battle these riders have ever had. They're both from Northern California. They started racing when they were 12 years old against each other in Supermoto. And back in 2010 in Supersport, they raced for the first time together on 600s. How did that end up? Cameron Beaubier beat Joey Pasquarella by 0.001 seconds. These two riders know each other very well.
And they're showing the respect like they know each other very well also.
And you can see they've ridden together many times right here, but I guarantee you Pasquarella wants to be on the other end of that deal when they finish this one. Martin getting a little wobble right there. He's throwing everything he's got at this man. He's got to cut a nice lap, 150.3 last night, but DeSalvo, 150 flat. He is flying on an old-used Dunlop tire, and he just running out of time, unfortunately.
7.7 seconds behind Joey Pasquarella. There he is, in the retro Triumph color scheme and leathers for the late Gary Nixon.
I'm not sure that Martin's out of this yet. I mean, he cut more out of him that time. He's under 4 seconds behind now. So if these guys in the front run into any kind of traffic that impedes their progress, it'll allow Martin to get that much closer. And sometimes, man, when you can see him that close, and he can't see him, you'll throw everything you got at it. Maybe he can pull it back.
Remember what we told you a little earlier about Martin Cardenas. He is a late race specialist. This is what he's become known for. Usually it's within elbow to elbow scraps,
right.
With
right.
Spectacular moves and sideways style, backing it into corners. But let's see if he can hunt them down.
I mean, right here, he'll leave this break in late as he possibly can, and diving into turn one right now, probably putting that front tire into all kinds of situations as he runs it. Like I said, ran it wide. See, he's overcooked it. That's what you do. You just try, and you got to try. You got to try. But turn one's so easy. Look at Pasquarella. He made a little mistake right there. So right now, a couple mistakes right there in the last couple of corners by the top three riders. So Beaubier's pretty steady back up front.
What do you think? Instead of fighting each other, these two need to team up. They've got to team up, because if they're fighting each other like it's the last lap now, Cardenas and DeSalvo will arrive on the scene unexpectedly.
You're exactly right. You took the words out of my mouth as I watched them come around the banking last time they came side by side. Let's stay in line, fellas, and keep that draft rolling. Let's move this freight train, keep it rolling. We don't want to get side by side, but, you know, these are their first times, you know, dealing with this kind of situation. So they're kind of just racing each other. See Martin right there sliding that thing up on. He's giving him Dunlops all they can handle right now.
Still 5.5 laps to go of this 3.5-mile circuit.
I tell you what, Cardenas took 0.7 of a second out of him last time by. It was 3.8. This time it's 3.3.
So the countdown continues. And now DeSalvo is within a lot closer margin to this man here, Cardenas, after that turn one incident and slight error.
Here we go again, like you talked about, side-by-side racing right here. Not sure that they realize the man behind him is coming as hard as he is.
5 to go now, 5 to go. And let's give you a margin. Let's give you a real time check here between Pasquarella, Beaubier, and Martin Cardenas. 3.3 seconds. What is it now? 2.9, and almost another half a second gone.
There you go. That's that one rider right there that they had to just wait. Let me wait and see what this guy's going to do. And the braking's under turn one, and that just allowed Martin to claw that little bit closer to him.
And with every lap that goes by, bike nine DeSalvo comes down by another second. With how many laps to go is exactly how much he's behind. 5 seconds behind is DeSalvo. This could very well come down to a last lap scramble like last year.
Cardenas, I got a real good feeling it's going to catch these guys. They keep swapping back and forth right here. And that's exactly what, look how close he is now. He gets by this guy clean, which, well, he needs to do that. Nice. Thank God he got by that guy right now. He's got a good run. Get this thing turned. Try not to get the thing sideways too much. Try to keep it hooked up. Man, he is real close now. But see, you can gauge that on these breakings, on these deep breakings. Now, when you got them right there in your sights, you just leave that a little bit later again. You saw him make a mistake in turn one. Let's see if he can continue to move up on him on these braking zones.
And with every out-braking maneuver and every pass attempt, these guys are inhibiting their ability to hold off Martin Cardenas. Here comes the Colombian.
The hook has been set, and he's reeling them in, man.
Through NASCAR 3 and 4, when they come across the finish line, it'll be four laps to go, and that is plenty enough for Martin Cardenas.
At the way things are going, it's definitely plenty for him, and here we go. They're going to fall back in line, get that two-bike draft going as they run right down that double yellow line. You want to stay low on this tri-oval. Get down there in that braking zone. You're down on the flat part of the track. Easier to break it hard down into turn one, and it flattens off, and you got to be very careful right there not to overcook it. Now,
the Geico Suzuki rider just took 1.7 seconds out of them on that last lap. Cardenas can still do this.
Well, you said it, Lee. He's the best at coming from behind, and he's really showing how good he is. Hopefully all these slower riders will get out of their way. Not now. That is not what Pasquarello wanted to see when he looked over his shoulder right there.
He is possibly the worst rider to have zeroing in on you because he is so good.
Did you see him come through that kink? He had that thing like a flat tracker coming out of there. That's fast. That's 130 mile an hour slideways side.
The two Yamaha riders suddenly have company. He's a Daytona Sport Bike champion. He notched up his maiden AMA Pro Superbike victory last year. He's back to get another sport bike championship, but guess what? He's never had a decent result at this racetrack. This could be the first time. He got the Rolex wristwatch for getting pole position. He could convert that into a victory. 3.5 to go, and Cardenas is on the scene.
What I expect to see right now as we come down in the chicane right now, let these two guys see, and then what I expect to see at the start-finish is a test run for Martin. Can I get these guys at the start-finish? I don't think you'll see him try to take the lead until the last lap.
How far back is DeSalvo? You're looking at the battle for sixth on the left with Jake Zemke, Tommy Aquino, Jake Gagne, they're all in there. Top three on the right-hand side of your screen with just three laps to go here at the World Center of Racing.
Looks to me like, Lee, he's just happy now he's caught up. He didn't even look pressured or worried about trying to sneak up on that draft. He's doing it all right here on the brakes. He said, man, I've run these guys back down from that far back. I know I can win this thing now.
From Cardenas in the yellow and black leathers to bike number nine is 2.5 seconds. So DeSalvo has got three laps to make up less than 3 seconds. That's achievable as well.
It can be done. Pasquarello keeps seeing that, and every time he looks over, and there he goes, Martin down the inside. He said, now you see me, I'm in front of you now.
And Joey Pasquarello has just said, where did you come from? And he says, from about 7 seconds back.
A long way.
How about that? And the nine now comes into the picture. The triumph is in the zone.
And you can believe that Martin is a smart rider. He's watching his pit board, and he may decide, hey, I'm not going to sit back here and wait till the end because I know number nine's coming behind me. I may have to get on up here and make this thing happen.
Remember how Jason DeSalvo won this race last year? It was with a pass coming through NASCAR Turn 4 into the tri-oval and got the victory by literally hundredths of a second.
Here we go again. Martin settled into that second spot right now. Bubby has really run a great way. Did I see DeSalvo run straight right there?
No, he's there. Made it. He's there.
He made it, and he made up some time on the brakes again. This is getting good.
Up on the 31-degree banking. All three decide to run high. What a great shot that is. That captures the top four. It shows you how much room DeSalvo has to make up.
It's a great shot by our camera crew right here, telling the story right here as they come down that start-finish line straight away right here. Three bikes tied together and one number nine back here all alone trying to make it happen.
Who do you want to win this? Do you like Yamaha? Do you like Suzuki? Or do you like a bit of history with Triumph in the legendary Gary Nixon livery?
What a ride by Jason DeSalvo. Look at this. He is right there with two to go.
The dream is not over. For bike number nine, it is alive. The dream is definitely alive. And there's the latest Motors team. They can't believe it. He was the first of the front runners to stop, and we thought there was a problem. He stretched that middle fuel run, and he's stretching this final one. He'll be on fumes by the time the checkered flag comes out.
Oh, he about ran over Martin right there. He is coming with a head of steam like nobody else, man. And now he knows I'm there now, and he knows my bike's fast. So let's see. He's probably going to do a little test run, or does he try to go out front? Now it gets tricky with 1.5 laps left. Now it's not a two-horse race, it's four now. So who can really pull this out?
No disrespect to anybody else, but nobody else counts. It's down to these four, folks. The next rider is Dane Westby, 41 seconds behind. It's a four-rider race. Two Yamahas, one Suzuki, and one Triumph.
I think you touched on this Westby. I think he just threw the towel in, so let's get some points. Now DeSalvo looks down the inside, not going to do it. He is going to do it. He takes that third spot from Martin Cardenas right now. And now the two youngsters are in trouble.
Wow. Look at this. He's not going to hang around and play games either. The two more experienced riders are going to get on with this job because they're coming to the white flag. There will be one lap to go when they cross the start-finish line this time by.
What an amazing race, Lee. This is just fantastic right here. As they come across here, tied together, all four of them, as they're going to dive out of here. Who wants to lead this last lap?
You got 3.5 miles to kick the season off and decide who's going to win the Daytona 200. Eight different winners in the last 8 years. Are we going to get a repeat winner in DeSalvo or a first-time winner from these first three?
Here we go to the International Horseshoe right now. It gets really tight. Cardenas up the inside of Bobier. He's taking that second spot away. Pasquarello leading the way down the infield straight away as they fly through this kink right here. This is it. Leaving nothing on the table right now. Everybody's throwing everything they got at this thing. Cardenas is going to look down the inside. He's going to settle in. Bobby around the outside. Man, this is tight.
You cannot afford to make an error. Not here, not now. Bring your best for this final lap. The youngster leads the way in what would be the biggest victory of his career. Same applies for Cardenas, same applies for Cameron Bobier, and the defending race winner is haunting them.
Let's see the speed of this Triumph as he gets that three-bike draft. I think he's laying back right here. He's gonna do a little test. He's gonna go for it.
DeSalvo to the inside. Is he gonna try and drag race him and out, break him down into the chicane? Remember what happened last year. Corey West hung back and let him go for it. DeSalvo squeezes through. There's almost contact.
Tight.
There's a lap rider in the way. Here they come. Who gets the better run? It's Pasquarello, Bobier, then DeSalvo.
Wow, this is crazy.
The Triumph is in the zone. Watch that blue and white bike. DeSalvo's going to go for it. He tucks down low. Pasquarello's high. Coming to the tri-oval.
Look at Cardenas coming on the outside. He's got a nice draft too.
It's Jason DeSalvo out of the draft, and Pasquarello will do it.
Wow.
The young man wins the Daytona 200. What a stunning victory for Project One Atlanta and March of Dimes, and a 19-year-old gets the biggest win of his life. What a finish. Unbelievable.
Here we go, Tommy Aquino and Jake Zimpke. He's still got something to settle, and that's Tommy Hayden right there with him, and Jake Gagne as well. Another four-bike battle down here to the line as they exit the chicane.
Good comeback, Tommy Aquino. That's been a great ride on the 827.
Oh, he's got a nice little gap right here. We got three guys running together on the outside. Can they catch Tommy Aquino as they run down that front straightaway?
to the line. Zemke's going to go around the outside. Tommy Hayden's in the mix. Look at this for a finish as well. Zemke will get there ahead of that pack.
Wow.
Good stuff. So Joey Pascarella, the young Californian, wins the Daytona 200. Woo! For the Project One team. We'll hear from him when we come back.